They are skillful.
Hello, art family, and thank you to all the new subscribers. I recently was inspired by some urban sketching YouTube channels where people were using these small pocket palettes from the Art Toolkit company, and I thought it looked really cool. I initially was kind of hesitant about the original concept, and I remember thinking it looked like a really neat idea, but I didn't know how practical it would be in my own sort of journey. I was tending to get bigger and bigger. I don't know if you've noticed watching my videos over the past 2 or 3 years. I've progressively been painting on location larger and larger. My regular size now is usually 16 by 20. And I feel like I've kind of gotten away from how I used to do a lot of sketches in small 5 by 8 or 8 by 10, which is what this is, sketchbooks. And I was watching these urban sketching channels, and it really made me miss sketching small, sketching in a sketchbook just for fun. And I got really inspired by Becky Iswara's channel, and she uses this Art Toolkit supplies for her paintings, and I thought it was really cool. And I had found out about this folio size. They fairly recently made this new folio size, which is larger than the original Art Toolkit, the small kind of business card sized palette. And they're all customizable. The bottom underneath the pans is a magnetic strip, and you can buy different sizes of mixing trays or pan sizes. I liked that they had these extra large pans, so you could do a limited palette in it, but have a nice big pan, because even though I enjoy sketching smaller, I still like to have a big area to pull color from, especially if I'm using these squirrel quill mop brushes that they contain a lot of water and they can splay out really big, and I like being able to pull across a nice big pan. So I was really impressed with this kind of larger folio palette, that you could get these larger pans and have these mixing trays in it as well. So I know for a lot of what I do, I like to have big puddles for my mixes. And when I was looking at the palette, I was a little bit concerned about that, because I especially when I'm working a little bit larger, and this is fairly large for a sketchbook. This is an 8x10 perfect sketchbook from Etcher. But I thought this little palette held up really well. So being inspired by these channels, I kind of did a little bit of research and checked out the palettes and then also their toolkit. So this is using the toolkit I have. You can see in the pocket of my pochette box off to the right, that is the Art Toolkit toolkit you can buy. And that I was really impressed with. That would be a really cool gift idea for someone in your family who's an urban sketcher or interested in art, but also it's very practical and it comes with really cool stuff. So I was very impressed with that Art Toolkit. It has a ruler in it, some pencils, a little tiny spritzer, and they also sell these sort of the little camping collapsible, I guess it's sort of like a shot glass size, which is really cool because I haven't seen that before. I like a tiny version of those collapsible cups, because I've had those in the past, but they're much, much larger than that. So I really loved this little toolkit, and I was really impressed with it. Now, not just to give it away, I love this palette. I'm going to get more into my thoughts on the palette, but I don't want to seem like they are paying me to do this. I went and I was inspired by the videos, and I went and I actually bought this stuff to make a video with, and then also for my own general travel around toolkit. So I just want to say, it may seem like this is a paid ad. This is not a paid ad. I just happened to really, really like this palette. I was very impressed with it. Initially, when it came in the mail, I had some concerns with the way the, because I usually paint with pretty large metal boxes that are kind of all coated in enamel, like a heavy enamel. And this is kind of set in inside the square and inside the palette. And so I was a little bit worried that it would get sort of marred or chip. And I was also worried that if I was heavy-handed with it, which I tend to be, I don't know if you've noticed in my other videos, or I'm pretty rough with my art supplies, and I tend to beat my palettes up because I use a lot of water. I like to work very big and wet into wet, and so I wasn't sure how it would hold up if I was doing a lot of really big, like just filling it with water and pulling it out, and then filling it with water and really kind of jamming the brush in there. And I will have to see how that lasts in the long run. I can't really speak for the longevity of it, although I have seen a lot of people who have used these for a long time. They seem like they collect stains a lot, but that's not something that bothers me. I know some people are kind of picky about getting upset about stains in their paint boxes that you can't quite clean out. That's never really bothered me. So I don't mind that at all. It got a little bit stained by the end of my sketching, but I was using some very bright stainable colors. It's cadmium yellow and carmine, which are both pretty notoriously staining for palettes. Here you can see I've switched to my 5x8 sketchbook. The actual Toolkit comes with a Moleskine 5x8 sketchbook that slips into it really well. And those are fine, kind of general all-around sketchbooks, but I don't find that the paper quality holds up really well, especially with my kind of very wet-into-wet approach to applying paint. It tends to sort of curl and potato chip and fall apart on me, but it's great if you're using an opaque medium or gouache. Or gouache on top of watercolor, but I have a hard time getting the watercolor to stay on it. So of course the other sketchbooks are more expensive, but that's what I'm using here. So I'm switching now to this. This is a perfect sketchbook 5x8, and you can see how the palette fits really nicely on it. And then when it folds, there's no palette as thin as this thing when it folds up. It still folds as thin as like a business card holder, so you could keep it in your pocket literally. And I just was really impressed with that. And even though it's so thin, I still felt like there was plenty of room for paint. It does not come with paint, so it is very affordable in that I think it's like 40, 50 bucks for the actual palette itself, but it doesn't come with paint, so you have to add your own paint. This is Daniel Smith paint, and I'm using an M. Graham white gouache on top. So that's it for my thoughts on this Art Toolkit palette and Art Toolkit itself. I really liked it. I appreciate you watching the video. I'll see you in the next one. In the meantime, happy sketching.